I have a piece of asynchronous code here. It performs some long-running I/O and terminates when all writing is over. The problem with this code is that it never reports how far it has got. You can see the application running. I want to see the progress here. And more! I want to make fun while showing progress. Oh, the task has ended. Thank you for telling. There is another issue in this application. Its main thread supports cancellation, but it never actually cancels anything. That is where the fun in this demo will begin. I will first show you a creative way of communicating progress from a task. It will be such a joy that I will do it again and it will entertain me even more. So I will try it once more, but it won't be funny anymore. You will see. Here is the first improvement to my application. I want to pull the keyboard, and once I capture the C key pressed, I want to signal the cancellation token. On a miss, I will wait for some 20 milliseconds before trying again, so this function will effectively pull the keyboard some 50 times per second. It should be sufficient just to spin this task before the long I/O operation begins. I am running the application again. I will press the C key at some point and, yes, the process has terminated gracefully before completion. Let's spice this up a bit now. What if there was a request to do other things after some other keys are pressed? Shall I implement one task per request? Here is a new idea. I will make this keyboard task cancelable, but it will not cancel any other task. Nor will it know the meaning of the keys it captures. Open your mind and think of a more widely applicable task than the one that acts upon just one key. Enter progress. Passing values between tasks and threads in general is a tricky business. A standard solution to communicate progress from the child task back is to use the iProgress generic interface. The generic type parameter is the type of the value you plan to pass from inside this task. Thread synchronization, UI synchronization context, all the hard questions now fall onto the concrete implementation of this interface. When the key appears on the keyboard, send it as progress. I am sure you have always seen task progress as a percentage or a counter of how much work was done. But as I said, open your mind and you will see more than just percentages. You will see that any item resulting from executing a task can become progress. I want to use another cancellation token to stop background activities. Await the keyboard task before completing work. I am playing nice here, but the question of consuming progress indications remains. How do we handle thread safety? How do we mutate the UI? Just use the progress concrete class, and it will do all the synchronization for you. This object will raise an event every time the progress is sent. You can subscribe to that event and perform any action in the context of this thread. Isn't that wonderful? Even better, you can pass a callback that will execute within the synchronization context you have here. Can you imagine how much code, and how cryptic code, hides behind this object? Yet all I do is get down into the method and write one line of code that does the work like threads never existed. I am running the application. Press the C button and the process will terminate immediately. This was fun, really. Let me show you how to make things move on the screen while the background task progresses. By the way, you can download the source code from this video and more than 100 other videos on my channel if you become a patron. I am genuinely grateful to every patron because they are helping thousands of others watch these programming videos for free. Follow the link to my Patreon page to access additional materials that are not available on YouTube. This is another background task which circles through symbols at a rate of 10 ticks per second. Every time it switches to a new symbol, this task fires a progress containing that symbol. Let me put this progress indicator into motion. Create the ticker and run it. Capture progress and print it on the console every time. Await the ticker at the end and we are done. Where is the synchronization code? Well, there is a ton of synchronization code somewhere, I guess. Look how cute this ticker is. My application is alive at last. Press C and it will terminate gracefully. Fine, let's get serious at last. I want this IO task to report percentage progress as it goes. I still want to make fun, but this won't be funny, as you will witness in just 1 minute. Let's start mildly by reminding the listener to reset any progress display to zero when the task starts. After each chunk of work, report new progress. This is so easy and simple, isn't it? Well, it is, but this implementation also hides a bug that will finally wipe the smile off my face. The playtime is over. First, look how nicely I have switched off the ticker. I have substituted a function that does nothing when it reports a new state. Now I can focus on displaying the percentage of the IO operation completed. If I passed this function to the progress object, would it work? Other experiments did, so let me try this out. It seems to work, but you cannot see me pressing the C key repeatedly. Why is the task still running? Oh, it has died at last. There is something fishy here, and I know what it is. This task is pumping so many progress events that it has clogged the main thread. This is a common mistake in async methods with progress. I must learn to behave and only send progress occasionally, making the UI look alive without choking it to death. Since this progress is a percentage, it only has 101 possible states. Why don't I keep track of the previously reported percentage and only raise the new notification when it changes? Regardless of the amount of IO performed by this task, it will generate 101 notifications or less. Any CPU can sustain that. Now I'm fine. Look how nice and smooth it is now. As soon as I press C, the task will cancel its work. The beauty of this solution is in the separation of concerns. I can introduce a different consumer for these events and inject that one instead. The new function is drawing a primitive progress bar. There it goes, the progress bar is moving. And the cancellation works like a charm. What else could you ask for? It makes sense to improve this solution by introducing strongly typed progresses. What does this integer mean here? I think some dedicated percentage type would fit better. You can download the source code from my Patreon page and see how I worked with strongly typed progress indicators there. And you can learn more about async and await in C#.